Thank you to Vandergraaf for sponsoring this month's edition of Road to Recovery. Visit their website for more information about the Vandergraaf drum motor designed specifically for heavy industry applications.
We touched on 2022 there, and maybe that's a good segue to kind of bring in the prospect of getting a highway bill passed in the new year. It seems like there's a lot of energy around that. Obviously, we didn't see something come forward over the last 4 years, despite there being high energy back in 2016, 17 for getting that done. But the fact that there's change coming in Washington, maybe gridlock, you know, with the Congress, depending on what happens with that Senate runoff in right. Georgia with those two races, seems like there's optimism, maybe even in the first 100 days to get something done for infrastructure. I know that probably doesn't change what 2021 is going to look like in terms of construction starts. Again, that probably affects 22 and 23 and beyond. But since you're an economist and you're all over this stuff all the time, what's your expectation? I mean, are you on board with some of that momentum, or are you more of a skeptic when it comes to a highway bill coming forward in 21?
Well, I think we'll take it broader and then call it, say, an infrastructure package. I want to be optimistic in this regard, but I think it's going to be very difficult to get anything major or sweeping through Congress in the new year. The Dems, of course, won the White House. However, when you look at Congress, they have a significantly reduced majority in the House. And even if they win those two seats in Georgia, that would give them a very slim majority in the Senate. So it just makes the sausage machine, you know, to get the legislation through, it just makes it much more difficult. So I think when we look back at what was passed prior to the election, at least passed through the House, that's HR 2, the Moving Forward Act, that was around $1.5 trillion that passed the House along party lines, and then was essentially DOA in the Senate. So I think the big takeaway here from the election is that we're unlikely to see something of that magnitude move forward. I do think that there will be an infrastructure package coming, maybe not within the first 100 days. I think COVID and the response to the pandemic and the rollout of the vaccine will be the priority, and especially if there's no stimulus passed between now and inauguration day, I think that's going to be priority one and two for the Biden administration. But we are anticipating that there will be some sort of infrastructure package approved at some point within the calendar year of 2021. What might that look like? I think for sure that there will be the reauthorization for the FAST Act as part of that continuing resolution that was passed back in September. They renewed the FAST Act or extended the FAST Act through September 2021. So that will certainly be rolled into it in terms of what we've built into our forecast. We've built in $300 billion starting in fiscal year 2022. And that's just the core highway portion of that reauthorization, that there would be additional funds for transit and whatnot. And that $300 billion would be a fairly sizable step up from the levels provided under the FAST Act. And where we came up with that $300 billion, that was essentially where the House and the Senate were prior to the election. There did seem to be a growing bipartisan and bicameral support for upping the dollar values on the transportation side. Where else where we might see infrastructure dollars, wastewater, sewer water, as well as drinking water programs. And I think taking it slightly away from pure infrastructure construction, I think there might also be some dollars funneled towards healthcare construction. I think one of the things that this pandemic has laid absolutely bare is the lack of surge capacity in hotels, in hospitals. And much of the construction on the healthcare side recently has been on that outpatient clinic side of the market and not so much on the inpatient side. So there is a significant lack of beds relative to population in many areas of the country. So I could certainly foresee some dollars being pushed into that market to support hospital construction in 2022 and beyond.
Thank you to Vandergraaf for sponsoring this month's edition of Road to Recovery. Visit their website for more information about the Vandergraaf drum motor, designed specifically for heavy industry applications.